most of the questions are coming from people who doubt. Can you translate it? In Sahaja Yoga, best thing is to practice what is said and then see for yourself, but if they are coming, I would like to tell them about
it.
Now the first one is about vegetarianism. Somebody has asked. Who has asked about vegetarianism? Raise your hand.
This one?
Ah, you, all right. Now, I said that there is no question of vegetarianism. Whether you are a vegetarian or not makes no difference to your meditation. But for people, you see, the food is only important because supposing you are Chinese, you eat too much of fish and all that. So to give it a balance, if you become vegetarian more, it will be better. It's a question of balancing. But those people who eat too much of, say, vegetarians, like in India, they should take more to non-veg or to proteins. It's a question of carbohydrates and proteins. It's not a question of vegetarianism. Now to say that Buddha was vegetarian is not true, it's false. Because how Buddha died, you know? Buddha died when he went to his disciple who had killed wild boar. And the wild boar is allowed to bleed for some time and then you should eat the meat. But he was in a hurry, so they didn't do that and he ate it and he died. Now the problem with all of you is one, always. Like whether you are Christians or Buddhist or anything, you are all conditioned by that. To you, Buddha is everything. What did Buddha do for you? Where is he? What is he doing? What did he do for the Buddhist? Did he give you realization? But you all are like that. Even the Christians are like that. They are so much conditioned by Christ. You see, they are either Christ or Muhammad Sahib or someone like that. But I am sitting before you. They are not here. Who has given you realization? Try to understand. So why be so much conditioned by Buddha? Buddha was never was a vegetarian. He died because of that. He ate that meat and he died. So it's a wrong idea that Buddha was a vegetarian. It's all myths they are going about, and there is no need to be vegetarian if you are suffering from too much of protein intake, you should take to vegetarianism. It's good for you if you have that problem. And in China, people eat so much of, say, fish. So they should take more vegetables with it, not only the fish, because with fish you have phosphorus. Now, do you know about your genes? We have a database of the genes. There are three things, there are carbohydrates, there is phosphorus, and there's nitrogen. Nitrogen is good for your health, for your ascent, for everything. But what happens? People eat too much of proteins and fish and all that, then they create more phosphorus. They become very right-sided. Their eyes are spoiled and the whole balance is lost. You follow the point? The balance is lost. So what you have to do... So, the people who are eating too much of phosphorus must take to carbohydrates. So, it will suit some people who are eating too much of proteins or too much of phosphorus, should take to more vegetarian food, will help. But it's not the way we should judge it by this, that by taking vegetarianism, you will become a realized social. Some people it will improve meditation, with some people it will not. For example, me, I can't take vegetarian food for more than 2 days. I get diarrhea, parasympathetic. I just get diarrhea. I cannot eat. I cannot also eat all the time fish. I have to eat a very much a protein food. See, for the goddess they offer a lamb or sometimes a goat. This is the reason. She has to take proteins. This is what it is, that she has to take proteins. And somebody has to take, say, more of, carbohydrates they should take. But it doesn't suit everyone. Now, we learned that several gurus in Hong Kong, who is this Sarah Lee? Alright. We learned that several gurus in Hong Kong promote prostitution free of charge and promise the followers that they can get rid of their karma once they give their faith to their guru, as they are also promoting internal peace and transcendence, and they do not change charge for anything. What are they aiming at? They are just aiming at in controlling you. Just they want to control some people, that's all. It's a power game. And that's what they want to do, is a power game. And I'm sure at certain point they must be taking money also. Now the thing is, if they were giving peace and they're talking about karma. I'm not talking of karma. I'm saying you have to go beyond your mind. And it has to be connected with scientific ideas. That you have to go beyond your mind. They never say like this, we'll get rid of your karmas, how can you? Who does the karma? Ask them. Ask them 5 questions, they'll be all right. They don't know about ego, they don't know about conditioning, they don't know about chakras, nothing they know. They might be cheating you just. It's just anybody can start something like that. But what is the validity? Validity is that do they talk relevantly, do they talk about the inner side, do they talk about the chakras, do they talk about the kundalini. Now you have got your kundalini away. That should give you faith, not in me, but in yourself. You have no faith in yourself, that's why you start thinking like this. If you have faith in your achievements, what you have achieved through Sahaja Yoga, you won't ask such questions. Alright, so this is over. This is over. Somebody, a new yogini, she said she cannot believe in her own feelings. Who is this one from Japan? Now, it's a. Now, see, there's nothing to believe in your own feelings, no question. You have to believe in your vibrations. You should see what sort of vibrations you get. Supposing you are very much inclined for something. So try to find out of someone, try to find out on your vibrations, you can find out whether it is true or not. Because now you have jumped into an awareness where you know the absolute. But it's not necessary that you have reached that state. But I'll tell you how to reach that state is different. But just now as it is, you have to go beyond your mind. And that is what one has to achieve. Alright? So how to go beyond your mind, that I'll tell you. Pamela NG. Alright. Now she says that when she came to first to meditation, she was sleeping very well, it was effective after and all that, and then later on started. Now see, if you are just thinking about yourself, vibrations will go down. It's not given only for your benefit. It's given for the benefit of everyone. If you are just worried about yourself, the vibrations will disappear. Because vibrations are there to give it to others, to work for others. If you are not collective enough, you cannot go. If you do not dissolve into Sahaja Yoga, you cannot go. And then when you don't grow, you go on falling down. And when you go on falling down, then you lose all these things. So how many people have you given realization? That's it. First you start giving realizations to others, then you will understand that how joyous it is to give realization. It's not meant for you alone, it's meant for everyone. All right? I believe that there are real gurus and false gurus in this world. If someone follows a real guru but not Sahaja Yoga, does this still do any good or for him? Who is this Christine? Now see, I haven't met anybody who is a real guru and who is giving realization to him. Who may be real, but he cannot give realization. That's the point. So what will they do? You see, they are very hot-tempered people, mostly. And they take you to task. They make you work very hard. But I haven't seen anybody giving realization so far. If you meet anyone, let me know. I'll be very happy to pass on. All these are over now. Mr. Ling, who is he?
Mr. Ling.
Now is it interesting the way you are seeing visions? Have you been to some other master before?
No.
No one. Now you see, for this best thing is to know about Tao, which is your speciality, it's Chinese, in which he describes, you see. Tao Lao Tse describes the journey through the river Yangtze. I went myself to see that. So he says on the side, or the banks, there are beautiful, very beautiful mountains and beautiful trees, and it's so beautiful that you feel like jumping out of the boat and going to these gardens and to these mountains. But what your aim is to go through this now is the Yangtze River, towards the river. So in the beginning, maybe there are some currents flowing, maybe you might lose faith in yourself, but by the time you reach near the sea, it becomes very silent and you have to go to the sea, as the point is. So you see, all these are there, these are just enticing, it's all right to see, but it's nothing important, because all this will keep you on a mental level. You'll be always thinking, what is this vision, what is that? There's nothing to be on the mental level. You have to go beyond, all right? If you don't see, don't bother about it. It'll disappear. Now, this is another one I'll test then later on. This August Kong.
Angus.
These questions are nice. The first one is about confidence, you see. And I'm going to tell you about meditation. If you do that kind of meditation, you'll get back your confidence, all right? That's one point. And then he says, if there's anything like destiny. In Sahaja Yoga, you decide your destiny. You don't have to depend on any destiny. Then, it's true, there is in Hong Kong, it's highly polluted. And a lot of people get allergies and things like that. But Sahaja Yogis should take bandhans, so they won't suffer with any allergies or anything. And also you can use something to cover your nose or something. I know that people are smoking so much, I absorb so much of this within myself. But this will all go away as far as you are concerned, because you are protected. All right? But the first one I'll tell you later.
Verna, in the Kremlin.
Werner, where is Werner? Now your eyes are suffering. So it's very simple, is that he's in Vietnam, is he?
No, in Hong Kong. But
he's in Hong Kong.
He's going to Vietnam soon.
Huh?
He's going to Vietnam shortly. Soon he's going.
All right. Now what you have to do? What is your digestion problem? You get diarrhea?
No, not diarrhea. But
constipation?
Not really at the moment, no.
But what is your digestion? No, what is your digestion problem?
Digestion.
Sometimes constipated.
What is it?
More constipation.
He's already right-sided. You are very right-sided person, see? And your eye trouble also come from the same. For the eye trouble that you are doing, you have to put eyes here. On the left-hand side from here to here, and also on your left. Alright? And your right-sidedness has to go. That I'll tell you how to do it, alright? This is a nice idea that they come to your program, and then they come to puja, and then they disappear. It's all right now. What can you do about it? There's no choice. See, they want to disappear, let them go away. We cannot force them. But maybe some of the people do not have proper behavior towards them, maybe. So you have to be careful how you talk to them and how you approach them. You should not be aggressive with them. And all that, maybe some of the reasons could be that. So that's very common. See, they come and go. Because this is the time of last judgment. If they want to go to false guru, let them go, because this is their choice. So we don't have to worry on that. But I think sometimes they leave because they do not do meditation properly. And I'll tell you what is to be done for that. <He's> sleepy. All right. Now we have to go beyond the mind. As I said it, that mind is a myth. And we live on a mental level all the time. And that's why so many questions and so many things, they come from your mind. If you reach a state where you are beyond the mind, you won't have any questions because you will be there. Because you are not there, you are asking this question. You are there for a short time and then you come down. So how to be more on that level, I'll tell you. Because I don't have that problem, you see. I can be all the time beyond the mind. But for you people, I've tried to find out how to make it, to keep you beyond the mind. Now, the best way I told people, and which has worked wonders, that when you are, wherever you are free, whether you are meditating or not, wherever you are freely standing or doing, try to see what is your mind is thinking. You separate now because you are realized soul. You have to be first of all connected. If you are not connected, you can't do this practice. But if you are connected to the mains, then what you should do is to see that your mind is thinking. Now watch your mind. Ask the mind, now, what are you thinking? Let's see. What are you going to think? And you will be surprised. You will go on watching and suddenly you will reach a point and you will become thoughtless. So always watch the mind. What is it doing? What is it thinking? What is it working out? And the mind will just stop thinking because it cannot answer, you see. It cannot answer a realized soul, you see. But for that, you have to be beyond the mind. To begin with, you should separate yourself from your mind. See, you ask questions to your mind. Now let's see, what are you thinking, sir? Where are you? In the mirror also you can see. You shouldn't suffer from narcissism, of course not. But what you have to do is to ask, not tell them. You tell him Chinese. Can you hear that? Not from the corner. You can understand? All right. Now, have you explained to them? Have you explained to them?
Yes.
See, if you try to understand how to become thoughtless, is the best way is to look at something. Now you look at something, say, look at the flowers. Now immediately it will react, your mind will react. Now you try to see what is your mind is saying. I don't want to hear. No, I don't want to hear. Just say, I don't want to hear anything. I don't want to know anything. I just want to watch. That's all. Gradually you'll grow. See, this is the system Zen tried to do it. But it was a circuitous thing, you know, that time. There were not such nice people like you, perhaps. So he had to use other methods to make people go beyond the thought. For example, I was telling just now about the tea ceremony. For tea ceremony, he would take a bowl of, say, freak, like a freak. He's made freak, you understand the freak? Freak is a thing which comes out by nature naturally in the cooking. When it is fired, it becomes a very funny type. That is the freak.
It's
not regular.
It's a pottery which is very unusual, very, very different. Like it's one of, unique, completely unique.
It's only one piece comes out. Something with a Japanese here who's come from Japan. You people, they like, that's why freak very much. You see. So, what he said that it is, you take the bowl in your hand for tea ceremony. That's the best thing. So first of all, you sit in a garden with natural trees and natural fibers of the wood and all that, sitting down. And you start watching that thing. Three times you move like this and three times like that. And don't think, that's his point first, don't think, you move it. And then you take that tea. The tea is so sour, so bitter, they say quinine raised to power 108. Once you take that, you become absolutely thoughtless. That's one. Then they give you a sweet. A sweet is also sweetness, sugar raised to power 108. You just can't eat. So you wear from one extreme to another extreme. Again, you become like that. It's like stunning. When they put this side and that side, suddenly it works out. But it's meant for people who already have got realization, not for people who have not got. That's why they're still studying Zen, you know, this tea ceremony. When we went to Japan, you see, in one hotel they had arranged this tea ceremony. And some Americans, they said one couple has to come. They were fighting. I'll go. We have had the experience, so we were keeping quiet to see what was going on. And one couple came forward, everybody was very jealous of them. They sat on the stage and then they brought the tea, they make it with a very great care and all that, and gave it to the wife. She drank it and she was stunned. You know. And then they gave it to the husband. Husband, you know, American after all, he got so angry, he threw the bowl. He said, damn it, you took so much money from us, and what are you giving us? He gave all kinds of American abuses to them, and they came away, and everybody started beating the people who had put up the show. So, this is meant for people who really want to go very deep in Zen. He also made a big courtyard filled with sand, with some sort of designs in the sand. And they put some stones in it. You are supposed to sit on the edge of that and to look at it without thinking. But normally people start comparing, it looks like shapes, it looks like bees. No, you have to just look at it. There are many such things he did, but nothing worked out with that. There are only 26 people who got realization in the Zen system in the 6th century, from the 6th century to the 12th century, and after that nobody got realization. But there were very few, and that's why they don't understand Zen at all. If people write Zen, because it's very deep and they don't understand. So that's what it is. Now, Sahaja Yoga is understood, can be understood by normally educated person, by even uneducated people. And this happens because actualization takes place. Your Kundalini takes an actual ascent, not tell them this. Now, in Sahaja Yoga, when people come in, there are different categories of people also. Some of them come because they think they can get good health. Once they get good health, they disappear. Then they again get some trouble, they come back. Just for good health. So you can't help. They have very limited desires. Then some people come in Sahaja Yoga for throwing their weight around. Showing off their ego, that I'm this, you see, trying to make another group, another this thing. You see, like that also some people come, very common, like a politics, you see. And they try to create against the leader, against this is wrong with him, that is wrong with him, and all kinds. Then the thirdly people come, but they don't come regularly to Sahaja. They do not come regularly to the center. They just keep aloof. And after some time they are lost. Once they again get some diseases or trouble, then they come. So it's a religious duty of all of you to come to the collective, one thing. The second one is to meditate every day in the night before sleeping on your mind. Everywhere you go, you should be in a meditative condition, in the sense you should ask your mind what is it thinking. All should come to collective. Every time they have a program, wherever it is, right? In Delhi I have seen people are really wonderful. There are so many people, at least about, I think 200 people, of course we have a good center there, 200 people, every morning they come for meditation, every morning. 200, look at these people. So the quality within, we call the pinda. See, the quality of a person depends on how much you want Sahaja Yoga. You just want to have all the advantages, you want to do everything. Like this lady, Sushmita Sen, she got the first prize. She is a Sahaja Yogini. She is a Sahaja Yogini and she meditates every day. Every day she meditates. And every day she used to come in the morning to our ashram in Delhi. She is a great Sahaja Yogini, I must say. But now she is in Calcutta and she is there also, she does the same. So the children also, some who are, this child is very highly developed child, this woman. I saw her yesterday. She's a born realist. And she is the one, she must be meditating, I'm sure, Well, she is a very highly developed person. She's got it from her last life. So she, you see, this kind of children, there are many who are meditating, or when they go to school also they become like that. So you have to first of all worry about correcting yourself.
Hello.
What is it? Which one part?
The third one is 有些瑜伽練習是非常好的。
Alright. Now, you see, so also another kind of people coming in Sahaj Yoga, they came, they made lots of money, this thing, that thing, still the greed is on. So if you still suffer from too much greed or hatred or you can call it a pride and aloofness and all that, then you must know that still you have to work out.
有些人来到沙卡瑜伽之后
Or if you are very angry type or attached, some people are very attached to their children. So in Sahaja Yoga they learn a lesson also from their children.
有些人就很容易生气的，有些人他是很执着，特别是执着于自己的子女的。
So one has to be introspective to see, are you just, are you satisfied? Then you can certify yourself that you are all right. There's so many types of people you'll meet, but what you have to see about your own asset.
有很多不同种类的人，但系我哋要特别知道嘅就系我哋自己，我哋自己嘅精进系点样。
So I've talked about God realization in my last speech in this thing. So you better listen to that lecture of mine. For this puja, for the Shiva puja.
Shimaji 喺最近一次 Shiva puja 嗰处咧，系曾经讲过神嘅。
So one should not even have ambitions about it. We are, when you have become a part and parcel of the whole, when you have become the ocean, what is there to be the ambitious? It's all individuality. You have to be a satisfied soul. And, I mean, like, I would say about myself, that I have to buy for my my children, my husband, this thing, that thing. But I never buy anything for myself. Very difficult. Very difficult to buy something for
myself.
And somebody says that, mother, please, what will you have? Another, I don't know what to say. What should I have?
有啲人问树 mother 住咧，你想要啲乜嘢 ？Mother 都答唔出啊，因为咧佢系冇谂过咧想要啲乜嘢。
I asked my daughter, you make all kinds of things for your father. What about me? So she said, You don't like something in particular, what to make for you? Tell us.
有一次，小媽住咧問佢個女啦，話佢買咗好多嘢俾佢個父親，咁有啲咩可以俾埋媽媽先啦？佢話諗唔到，因為媽媽咧好似冇咩特別想需要嘅。So
all these attachments, some people have got attachments with clothes. You see, what I'll wear tomorrow, I'll wear day after tomorrow, like that. But no, spontaneously, whatever is available, you can wear.
有啲人咧係執著於佢嘅衣服啦，譬如佢希望著點樣嘅衣服啦。但其實呢個係自然就得㗎啦，唔需要擔心咧，我哋穿著點樣。
And some worried about their past, you see, had a bad childhood, this, that, and they write about their parents, this. It's all nonsense. Forget it. You be in the present.
有些人呢,就是緬懷他的過去,說他的童年怎樣不開心,他父母怎樣對待他,這些都應該忘記他,只是關心現在就行了。
Now you are no more a seed, you have to grow.
現在我們不是一粒種子,我們要發芽生長了。
That is something one has to understand in life, that if we have to grow ourselves, then what we have to see within ourselves, what lies, where that is doing wrong. That is something missing.
所以呢,如果我們要去生長的時候呢,我們要了解自己內裡呢,究竟有什麼是錯的,或者有什麼是缺少的。
Best is to see the good points of others, not the bad points.
首先呢,我們要做到就是看見別人的好處,不要看見別人的壞處。
By that you will gradually develop more good points within yourself.
咁樣呢,我們能夠自己發展到那些好處出來。
Competition should be in good points.
如果有競爭心的時候,應該有些好的地方去競爭。
So on one side, you have to achieve your self-realization in a way that you put yourself beyond the mind only, through meditation.
一方面呢,我們要實現我們的自覺,達到這個超越思維的境界,通過靜坐去做到。
And the second way is to give realizations to others.
另一方面呢,我們要將自覺給其他人。
And must attend collective meditation, very important. You have to be active in it.
同時呢,我們要一定要參加集體的靜坐,而且是很活躍的。
If you are not active in such yoga, then you lose your vibrations gradually. Because divine things, what's the use of giving to this hopeless case any vibrations?
如果一個人不是很活躍,他的能量就會慢慢消失,因為上天是會這樣看的,這些能量留在人生上有什麼作用呢?
So you have to work it out. Understanding that now you are chosen as the instrument of the Divine.
所以我們要明白呢,就現在我們已經是被上天選擇成為的工具。
It is not only for your health, or for the health of your family, or for anything like that, but it is for the good of others.
這個不是為了我們的健康,或者家人的健康,而是為了其他人的好處。
That's how you will all grow very well.
咁樣我哋就能夠咧生長得好好啦。Now
like diffidence comes through your mind only. Mind only gives you diffidence.
我哋嘅思維咧，只會使我哋有好多缺點。
So to overpower this mind, you must watch and tell him to shut up.
要超越呢個思維咧。You
must tell it to shut up.
我哋要靜觀，同時咧叫我哋嘅思維停止，唔好再出聲。
Then you will rise.
我們能夠升上去了。The
proof is that you feel the vibrations.
我們能夠得到證明,因為這樣我們就能夠感覺到能量。Now,
if you ask me, I find the people in Hong Kong are rather right side.
So
you have to do right-sided treatment for yourself.
所以我們要特別做多些右邊的那些治療法。
Every night, about 10 minutes at the most, you have to sit with your right hand towards the photograph and right foot in the water with a little salt.
每一晚我們要做浸腳10分鐘左右,右手向著相片,腳浸在一盆水,有些鹽。
Normally use cold water, ice also is good, but cold water normally, but if it is very cold outside, you can use warm water.
我們一般可以用冷水,甚至是冰水。如果天氣很冷,我們可以用冷水。
In this hand, you must take ice and put it on your liver. Right hand towards the photograph.
我們左手可以有些冰按在我們的肝臟上,右手就向著Shimaji的上方。Alright.
Now, then after that, you can put the ice over here.
接著我們可以將冰箭放在頭頂自我的地方,左腦的地方。
If you do it every day, your stress will go down, everything will be perfect. Just put like this, just now. You feel it going down. No. Put right hand towards me. And the left hand. You are left sided, you are not right sided. So you have to use the candle, alright?
有些人呢,他是不是右邊,右邊,左邊的,那些呢,是用竹竿的調法。
Now, some people have both problems.
有些人呢,左右兩邊都有問題的。
Then you have to put a candle in front of the photograph, put both the feet in the water and sit like this.
他們可以在Shimaji的相片面前放一支蠟燭,雙腳浸在水裡面,然後雙手平放。And
in both the cases, don't close your eyes.
同時他們可以靜坐,不合上眼。You
should put your attention on my Agya. It will be very good for you, for your ascent into the realm of thoughtless awareness.
同時他們可以將注意力放在Mother的
As I love you, try to love me. That's the best.
最好的方法呢,就是,Shimaji更愛我們,我們都好像一樣。
Lastly, you see, in Sahaja Yoga, people come in, they think it's a sort of a contract with us, that we should look after them, their health, their jobs, their everything.
有些人以為來參加沙哈加瑜伽,就好像簽了合同一樣,Mother要照顧他的健康、工作。This
is absurd.
這是荒謬的想法。The
contract is between yourself, with yourself.
這是跟自己的合約。
You have to work it out.
是我們要自己去解決這些問題。
Alright? This is what it is. So, if the mind is asking questions, ask it to shut up now. Mind is the worst thing. It is standing between you and reality. Tumhara agya bahut jabardast hai. Samalo. Dono ko. Aapka bhi bahut hai, inka unko piche mein unka bahut zyada jabardast hai. Aankh nahi ruk rahi. Aankh roko. Steady karo. और आपके पति का भी बड़ा जबरदस्त आ गया है Now, whatever it is, like yours, you see, you give a bandhan to your husband. Ask everybody to give a bandhan to him, just now. You can give bandhan to him, that's her husband. Atul is his name. Just give him the mantra. See, it will work out. You can help. All of you can help. You can help the whole world. But you have to be strong. You have to have the energy within yourself. This is very good. This is Saju school. So try to remember what is your real problem. You are right-sided or right. So just try to cut it off.
We need to know our own problem. If we are from the left or the right,